morning class. So in my previous lecture, I have explained you about that covalent character of the halides of 14th, 15th group. And I have explained that which one is like, we have discussed the Fassan's rule and all that. So that leads to a new part, new topic that is called inert pair effect. So let me explain this. What is this inert pair effect? Inert pair effect says that the reluctance of NS electron in participating in bond formation in heavier P block element. Heavier P block element, there are few elements when we go down the group. Okay, that the NS electron, that configuration we know NS2, NP1 to 6 hote. Yes, so NS electron doesn't participate or they don't want to participate in the bond formation when we go down the group. Okay, they reluctant. So that is known as inert pair effect, and due to which we know that they show two type of charge oxidation number valency, you can say, that is like nitrogen, you know, plus 3 and plus 5 also. So when we go down in that group, that plus 3 stability will be more rather than plus 5. Got it? So here it is says that due to which ongoing down the group, stability of G minus 2 will like, for the P block, we know group how we find group. Group is like found to be like valence electron plus 10. So here we will exclude this 10, and that is like group number. Okay. So group number minus 2 increases with respect to group number. Like 3 ki stability increase hogi 5 se. Like if you go in 14th group, so 2 ki stability zyada hogi with respect to 4 oxidation number. Got it? So it is like that. So there is a question. Although SB and BI are of same group, but SBCl5 is more stable than SBCl3, while BICl5 is less stable than BICl3. What is this? Let me write over here. This is, I am writing SBCl3 and BICl3. And here I am writing SBCl5 and here BICl5. So it says that in this one is more stable, but if we talk about this, this becomes more stable. Why? So again, we come down. Yes, Nana Patekar, Aishwarya, Sub Bimar. So bismuth is down the group. That means for this, if we are comparing these two, for this group number, minus 2 ki stability will increase, isn't it? So yahan pe BICl3 will be more stable, while for above one, SBCl5 will be there. Got it? Maybe question can be asked with this, like with the comparison to this ASCl3 and ASCl5. If this would be the pair, then what will happen? This one will be more stable and this one will be less stable, like that. Got it? So question can be asked in that form. So we have to understand that heavy P block element and heavy P block element like these three. Similarly, for 4th group, 14th group, we can go SN and PB. Yes, for 14, 15, and for 16, we can go for selenium and tellurium. So like this. Okay. So can you mention it? Can you explain this? Because of inert pair effect. Yes. So let me write over, because of inert pair effect. And here, if it is asked in as a form of question, you have to explain this. Got it? That inert pair effect definition you have to explain, and their consequences also you have to explain. Got it? Now, let's do some reaction of halogen with water. When we talk about the reaction of water, reaction of halogen with water, actually these two reacts like same. Inki different hoti aur iski bhi different hoti. Iski kyu different hoti? Because of high electronegativity, small size, anomalous behavior, that's why iski different hoti. Iski kyu? Because of bigger size. Bohat zyada bada ho jata size, so iski wajah se iska different hota hai. So we'll talk one by one. Let me explain with this. If we talk about this, so we know that F2 is most oxidizing agent, isn't it? So if it is oxidizing agent, that means it, here the oxygen is in minus 2, it will oxidize the oxygen. So if it is oxidizing the other, that means it is self-reduced, isn't it? So F2 reduce ho ke niche kya jayega? Minus mein. So F minus, with this H it will form 2HF. With this minus 1 state, let me write with this 2HF. Yes, here oxidation state of fluorine is minus 1, which is considered as reduction, isn't it? And now oxygen will be oxidized in form of O2. So here it is oxidized. Why it happens so? Because we know that fluorine has most, like it is having most oxidizing power. It is a very good oxidizing agent, isn't it? Okay, now what about these two? ये जब react करेगा तो क्या होगा? So this is a simple reaction. You have to learn that it will the self, the chlorine and the bromine itself will undergo disproportionation reaction. And if for reduction it will give you HCl, and for oxidation it will give you HOCl, where chlorine is in chlorine is having plus one state. This is plus one, and this is minus two. Got it? So here it is minus one. That chlorine itself will undergo disproportionation reaction. Got it? And this is called hypochlorite. We will do afterward. And now Br2 plus water. This will also in same way HBr and HOBr. Hypobromite, where bromine is in plus one state, and here it is in minus one. What about iodine? Actually, if we want to make this reaction is not possible. No reaction. But if we change the reaction, if we do the reaction of iodide ion in acidic medium, in presence of oxygen, obviously. So, if we take iodide ion in presence of oxygen in acidic medium, then it will give you the same product like I2 plus H2O. But if you say, ki ma'am, this is giving this, so we can reverse this equation? No. Reversibility is not possible in this case. This don't react, but when these two, these three react, they give this. So, ye ek important point hai. You just remember this question, because this question is asked and can be asked. Got it? Okay, and out of this, one very important question of JEE Mains is, out of this four fluorohalide, which one is the good source of oxygen? Which one is good source of oxygen? Now you yourself can say which one. Yes, of course, this one, because aur koi oxygen de hi nahi raha, isn't it? So fluorine, when reacts with water, fluorine considered as a good source of water, as a good source of water when it reacts with water. Good sets of here I should write oxygen. Good source of oxygen when it reacts with water. It's a very important point and can give you 4 mark in that MCQ. Okay, got it? Okay. And why this reaction is not possible? Because we'll say that due to the bigger size of iodine, due to bigger size of iodine, it is not solubilized. It is bigger size, it is not solubilized. Solubilized. Got it? Is soluble nahi ho pata, and that's why this reaction is not possible. Okay? So now, let me talk about the oxidation number, valency and valence electron. So for this, I just want to explain the few things that you have to see. There is fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine are there. Yes. So fluorine is the only element which will show only two states. That means maximum is zero and minimum is minus one. Why? Because being highest electronegative element, it doesn't show any other oxidation state except minus one. Got it? Okay, there is one. Okay, let me write this thing. So here, class, I have written that why the oxidation number, why it shows minus one, because fluorine is being highly electronegative element, it highly electronegative element, it doesn't show any other oxidation state except minus one. It has the great tendency to reduce itself. And why so, you have done in electrochemistry also, because with the reduction potential term, isn't it? But while bromine and iodine, they are of the same group. First, let me write that what is the range of this minus valency to plus valence electron. That means it will be minus 1 to plus 7. So we can understand that all that 17th group element, they can show minus 1, minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, plus 5, plus 6, plus 7, isn't it? But out of that, fluorine, the topmost element, being more electronegative, it doesn't show any other oxidation state except minus 1. And while jo niche ki baat karte hai, if you talk about the lower one, like bromine and iodine, they due to the higher, bigger size, atomic size, itna zyada ho jata hai, because of that, they experience the steric hindrance, and that's why they also cannot show more than plus 5. Zyada polarization bhi possible nahi ho paati, so they cannot show more than plus 5. There is one exceptional note, you can heard this, you have done it in class 11th, that HOF is the only compound where the fluorine shows plus 1. And why so? There is another theory about it, I will explain later on. But you just learn this. Fluorine has only one compound, HOF, where fluorine is in plus 1 state. Otherwise, everywhere it is either in the negative, or if it is in the free state, it will be 0. Got it? So, now the next thing, if we talk about the oxidation number, let's, the chlorine is having great range for this oxidation number. So, we will discuss the chlorine. So, the first one is chlorine, that is Cl minus, it is zero minus state. Here it is in zero state, let me write over here minus 1 state, Cl minus. In this case, it is plus 1, here it is minus 2, plus 3, isn't it? And this next is ClO3 minus, where the oxidation state of chlorine is in plus 5, and here it is in plus 7. So one more thing you can learn, you can write here, that only the chlorine and manganese, non-metal chlorine and metal manganese, these are the two elements which can show plus 7 oxidation state. Okay, and osmium is the element which can show the plus 8 state. Baki rest, all the elements, they cannot show not even a single element other than this can show more than plus 6. Got it? So this is the thing. Okay, so now if we hydrolyze this in presence of water, this will give you HCl. Got it? Similarly, if you hydrolyze this, it will give you HClO4, where the oxidation number will remain same, isn't it? And other things, if I want to write and if you hydrolyze this, we will get HOCl. Okay? So, what the thing says here, if the plus 1 state lower than the expected one, so then it is called hypochlorite. This one, you know, chlorite. This one will be chlorine and this one will be hypochlorite. Sorry, it should write TE. It's TE. Hypochlorite. Got it? And if you talk about this, it will be considered as where the plus 5. It is called chlorate. And if you go above than this 5 cuper, then it will be called perchlorate. Got it? Okay. If it is hypochlorite, you can say it is as a chlorite. This one is chlorite. Done? Okay. If this exists in form of oxide, so we can make oxide or we can write an oxide Cl2O3. If it exists in oxide, we can write Cl2O5. This one we can write Cl2O7 as oxide, isn't it? Yes. And if we hydrolyze this, it will give you HClO3, where the oxidation state is plus 5. Any doubt in this? Done. So this is the naming and the oxidation state. You have to learn this compound. We'll do later on, we'll do in detail later on, okay? Okay, so now the preparation of chlorine, and that we will do in next class. So, till then, thank you, class.